Welcome to part two of our motion lighting series. We're tackling some of the advanced options in the app, so let's get to it. In part one, we set up a very basic motion lighting app, but not everything in life is basic. So let's complicate our plan a little bit to show you how to automate it with motion lighting. So going back to our original bathroom lighting plan from video one, I know that my bathroom gets a good amount of daylight, so we don't need those lights to turn on all the time, just when the lux value is below 250. Also, I don't want the lights to suddenly turn off when I'm in the shower, so I put a second motion sensor in the shower that I want to add to this plan to keep the lights on. My closet is also connected to the bathroom. Those lights are controlled by a separate rule, but I want to make sure the closet lights turn off when I leave the bathroom too. Finally, I have a switch by the door that I want to be able to use to override everything and shut the bathroom lights all off if I want to do that. So with that, let's dive in. So we're going to start, we're going to open up the bathroom lighting app that we've already created. And you see everything here is all set. So we're going to go into our options for activate, disable, and enable lights on. So here we see a whole bunch of different options we have here. Now in our rule, what we're trying to do, we want to add a lux value down here. So we're going to select the device to measure our lux. We're going to choose the master bath lux sensor right there. And we're going to select that to turn it on at 250. When anything above 250, we'll keep it off. So that's how we add the variable about lux. Now you'll see there's a whole bunch of other options. There are a few terms you need to know here. This activate option, you select a button and the lights will come on immediately. Disable on is essentially an off switch or an off button for the motion sensors, so your lights will not turn on even if they sense motion. These two enable options do the reverse, essentially turning your motion sensors back on. And then we have this option to restrict your lighting rule between two times. So now we're going to go into our options for additional sensors, lights off and off options. So here it offers for additional motion sensors. This is the shower sensor we were talking about. So the sensors you select here will not turn the lights on, but they will keep the lights on if they sense motion. Additional switches to turn off. This is the closet light we have in our new rule. What it's going to do is this light will not turn on when motion is sensed, but when all the lights are shut off, this light will shut off too. This button to push one off will do the same thing if you have a button that controls your other light instead of a switch. Here you can select a button or switch to activate off. This will mean these buttons or switches will turn the lights off immediately. We have a switch. This is our master bath master switch right by the door that will override the system and shut all of our lights off. And finally, we have our disable options. These three things, buttons, modes, and switches to disable turning off, essentially overrides the end of your rule and will allow the lights to stay on indefinitely regardless of whether the motion ends or not. Okay, now we've selected all the options we want for this rule. You'll see it says additional motion sensors null. That just means we selected a motion sensor, that shower sensor, that will nullify the light off rule. So that's good. Everything else looks good. We're gonna click done and our rule is saved. As you can see, there are just a ton of ways for you to customize your motion lighting apps. So give it a test drive and see what you can do. For more motion lighting ideas, join the conversation in our online community at community.hubitat.com. We have one more video on mode lighting in our motion lighting series, so check that out. But for now, thanks for watching, and thanks as always for elevating your environment with Hubitat.